everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm here today with Odin. He's gonna be chilling out here. He's a little bit tired because we just went on a long walk today, and so he's ready for his nap. So today I'm gonna do a video all about poodles because I do get a lot of questions about poodles. There's a lot of misunderstanding, I think, about poodles. People don't really know, you know, if poodles are just this like silly frou-frou breed with silly haircuts. That's kind of the picture that a lot of people have about poodles, and I want to inform you guys all about poodles, that they're really not like that. They're just incredible, versatile dog, and I get a lot of questions actually for people who want to get a poodle and are just not really sure, so I thought I would do like pros and cons. So Odin is a standard poodle. So standard poodle just refers, sorry if the light keeps changing, it's because I'm sitting here at the window. Standard poodle just refers to the size. So the standard poodle just means he is the biggest poodle breed. They do come in different sizes. So there's the middle size, and then there's a small size as well. I wasn't interested in the smaller sizes of poodles because I always just wanted to have a big dog. I wanted to have a dog to accompany me on my running and hiking and all that kind of stuff. So for me, really, the large size breed was the one that I wanted to go for. First of all, poodles are the second smartest breed in intelligence after border collies. So because they're very intelligent, they're actually great for first-time dog owners because they are very easy to train. I'm a first-time dog owner, and I didn't want a dog that was very difficult to train, and I didn't want a dog that had, like, you know, dog aggression issues and all these kind of things that, you know, some dogs are just harder to manage, like, you know, German Shepherds, or, you know, there's certain dogs that you just need to have a little bit more knowledge about what you're doing. Very easy to train. I remember when I was teaching Odin how to sit and, you know, sit, stay, down, all those kind of things, he was very fast at learning that. I think I taught him sit, stay, and down in one day. Not that he got it down pat every time, but I could teach him three commands in one day. That's pretty unusual for most dogs. So some dogs, you'll need to repeat it over and 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 over again until they learn it. I think I did it two or three times just trying with treats, and he got it, I think, on like the third try or something. They absolutely do not shed. So I have a blanket. You can see he's like lying on a blanket here, but the reason is really only just to protect the sofa because it's a leather sofa. It's really not to protect against dog hair because you can see he's lying on these pillows back here. If he gets up and walks around, there's not a single dog hair on those pillows. There's really no shedding. So the only time that really hair comes out is when I'm brushing him. Otherwise, there's really no dog hair lying anywhere on the floor here. There's no dog hair on the pillows that he's lying on right now. So that's really something I did not want. I hate animal hair lying around my house. Poodles are a great option if you have pet allergies. You should get tested for poodles, or maybe spend time with the poodles, because I do have sensitivities to pet dander, and I absolutely have no issue with him. So hypoallergenic does not mean that you will not have any allergy, but it just means there is a much reduced chance of being allergic to poodles than there is to other dogs. So if you're someone who has, you know, pet dander sensitivities, that's something you want to consider. If you are allergic to dogs, you should spend time with poodles first, because you should figure it out before, obviously, because you don't want to get a dog and then have to get rid of him because of your health. Another thing that I really like about poodles is that they absolutely do not drool. There's no drooling involved here. Oh yeah, so you want tummy rubs. So he really he really doesn't drool. Another thing is that he does not bark or yap and stuff for no reason. So of course he does bark every now and then, but it's more as a warning. So if he's kind of like a watchdog. We didn't train him to do that, but poodles are amazing watchdogs. So they will alert you if someone is coming to your front door. They'll alert you if they hear a weird sound. He doesn't yap. He's not like a yappy dog breed. I think the smaller poodles are more prone to yappiness in general, but that is because that's with small dogs in general are more prone to barking. The only time, like he's, like I say, he does bark is when somebody's coming to the door and he alerts us, hey, there's somebody there, like he barks. But then I go to him and I was like, okay, that's fine now. Like, I know that the guy's there at the door, like stop, and then he stops. They are incredibly affectionate dogs. So he is always coming up to me. He wants pets, he wants to snuggle. Like right now, you know, he wants me to rub his belly. You know, at night he'll come up to me and he'll snuggle up to me. So they're very, very affectionate dogs. Even the large breed, I think the small breeds as well, and the small breeds will like come onto your lap and stuff. He tries that when I'm lying, son is here on the sofa watching TV, he'll come up and he'll put his head on my lap. And so they're very, very affectionate. That's something that I just love about him. I always wanted to have like a super affectionate, loving dog. And they're also very friendly to other people. So if, you know, if someone new comes to the house, there's definitely no growling. I don't think I've ever heard him growl ever, and I've had him for over a year now. They're very friendly to strangers, but they're not as friendly as I would say, like they're not as go-getter as a Labrador or a Golden Retriever who will run up to everyone and instantly be their best friend. They're a little bit more reserved when they meet a stranger, and I actually prefer that because some people do not like dogs. Poodles will not just like run up to a stranger and want to be their friend. They're kind of a little bit more timid when they meet someone new, but I honestly prefer that. And also they are very friendly to other dogs. That's the thing. There are some dog breeds that you have to be careful when they meet new dogs because there might be dog aggressive, want to dominate the other dog, and poodles are not like that at all. He gets along with every dog. He's never like had a dog fight or anything like that. Just calm, and you know, first he wants to check the dog out and then they start playing. He's super playful with other dogs. They're actually super athletic dogs. Now a lot of people don't know this, but poodles were actually bred to be hunting companions for waterfowl. So you can use them for duck hunting. If you're a hunter, you should definitely think about getting a poodle because they are incredible hunting companions. Love anything to do with water. So he loves splashing on the water. He loves swimming. He loves the snow. They're very, very outdoorsy, very athletic. You can do all kinds of sports with them. I go running with him. I go hiking with him. You can even do cool stuff like agility courses where they do like obstacle race courses for dogs. The poodles absolutely excel at that kind of stuff. And what I've also found is that they're so funny and like outgoing and clownish. So sometimes he will just make us burst out laughing because they're so derpy sometimes. You know, they'll be jumping around and doing the derpiest things. And, you know, sometimes he'll go and, I don't know, like chase something. It's just hilarious. Sometimes they have very, very big personalities. Wonderful, funny, playful dogs. So I think a lot of people see poodles from like show, dog shows, and they're always standing very regal, and they've been trained to do that. That's not the natural nature of a poodle to like stand there. You can train them if you want to do dog shows and stuff. You can absolutely do that with your poodle. That's not something I'm personally into. And they are actually quite suited to apartment living. They don't need a ton of space in the house. Like we live in a bigger place now, but you know, they don't need a ton of space inside. They're very calm inside. He spends a lot of time like this, lying around on the sofa, you know, snoozing. If I'm filming my videos, he's usually lying on the floor next to me, snoozing. They're very calm indoors. The only thing is that they do need quite a bit of exercise. The reason he is like this now is because we went on a super long walk. I mean, I would say he needs a daily walk of at least 1 hour plus. If I don't take him out for an hour long walk every day, then he has not had his required amount of exercise. Usually I take him out for one super long walk and then he'll get like another little walk in the evening. So you do need to make sure that you have enough time to exercise your dog, especially with a poodle, because they get bored because they're so intelligent. So this is kind of a pro and a con. Because poodles are very intelligent, they need a lot of stimulation. They need either a lot of exercise or, you know, a lot of play times. He does need quite a bit of playtime. So I have a lot of toys for him, but he doesn't like to play with his toys by himself mostly. So I have to like play with him with his toys, you know, not all the time. Like sometimes he'll play by himself, but I have lots of like stuffed animals and balls and other things that he can play with. I can, you know, throw the ball for him. He can go get it. So you do need to spend some time with poodles, just because I tell you, like, otherwise they're going to get bored and destructive if they, you know, don't have anything to do. But he has never actually destroyed anything in our house because he does get enough exercise and he gets enough stimulation, I guess. Yes, look at you, you're so cute. If you're kind of like stumped on what to do, if you think your poodle needs more stimulation, is enroll them in some agility classes, do agility with them, or like advanced dog training classes. You can even teach them tricks. Like I've taught them a couple tricks. They love to do tricks. You can do obedience classes where they really have to use their brain and things like that. So you really want to make sure that you have enough time to spend with your poodle. As for exercise, like I said, at least an hour a day, I would say that's the minimum. I let him off leash. I think if I was just walking with him on a leash, I don't know if he'd be satisfied with that. So I always go to places where I can let him off leash. You can, if you live in the city, you might have to go to like a dog park or something like that. Another kind of con or something you want to keep in mind with a poodle, and this is kind of the most important thing, is grooming. Now I said that they do not shed at all, so they don't lose hair, but they need to be groomed very regularly. You can either teach yourself how to do it. I attempted that route. I bought the grooming equipment. It's a like a shearing tool. It's, you have to kind of imagine they're like a sheep and you're shearing a sheep because they don't lose hair. You have to like physically cut their hair. It's very, very thick. So you have to buy a proper tool for it. I bought one. It was very expensive. But if you do plan to do it yourself, make sure you really think about that, because that's what I planned to do. I was like, oh, I'm gonna do it myself. So I bought the thing and it is very difficult. I think, you know, practice makes perfect. If you keep doing it over and over, for me, I found it quite challenging, and I decided that it just took me personally way too long, that I just felt like it was kind of a waste of my time. I would rather pay someone else to do that. We've decided to clip him, and I mean, it's summer now, so he gets very hot, so we've clipped him very short. It's a little bit longer on his head. You know, we just keep him short here so that we don't have to brush him as much. That's the other thing. You know, in between grooming, you can't just expect to take him to the groomers every now and then. You have to brush him pretty much every day. So now that his fur here is very, or his hair rather, is very short here, I don't even have to brush this entire thing because the hair is so short. The only thing I have to brush right now is his head, his ears, and his tail, because we've decided to keep his tail bushy. So very regular grooming, I would say every like 6 to 8 weeks. I think like 6 weeks is pretty early. We take him about once every 2 months, every 3 months in the winter, because in the winter we are planning to, you know, make sure that his hair is a bit longer because it gets cold here. So it's protection for the cold as well. Just consider that, because if you are going to the dog groomer, that's a considerable cost you need to factor in. I don't know where you live. I mean, here it's upwards of 100 Swiss francs, which is about $100 each time. So it's about between 100 and 120 Swiss francs or slash dollars. Plus, like I said, daily brushing. You need to buy a good brush. I have one by Christensen. So that's another thing. Sometimes at the end of the day, you're tired and you don't really feel like brushing your dog. Well, you have to, because especially if this hair is longer, you need to brush very regularly, because otherwise there will be matting. And once the hair is matted, it's almost impossible to get it out. They'll have to probably cut it off next time you go to the salon. You know, that's why we've kept it short also, just to make it easier on him and us for brushing. He doesn't really love to be brushed, so it's just easier for both of us. And I like him like this. I don't really love the classical poodle cuts. Poodles, you can cut them any way you want. You can clip them all short, one length. You can do these crazy hairstyles. If you want the classic crazy poodle look, you have to like blow dry them and all that kind of stuff. So the pro is that, like I said, you have no dog hair around, so you're gonna spending a lot less time cleaning your home, washing your throw pillows, vacuuming and stuff like that. So that's kind of like the balance there. And another thing that a lot of people don't actually realize with poodles, it depends on the line and depends on each particular poodle. They can have a prey drive. They have an instinct to chase animals chase and hunt animals. So poodles do have a natural prey drive. Like I said, they were actually meant to be used as hunting companions. Or some poodles have a very strong prey drive and some don't. Odin, thankfully, doesn't have much of a prey drive. He has a little bit of a prey drive, but not crazy. Like, he will chase after cats, and you know, if we're in the forest, I kind of have to make sure he doesn't run off, but it's not crazy. But I do know that some poodle owners have a poodle with a very, very strong prey drive that they always have to have him on leash. If you're wanting a poodle to use as hunting, then you probably want one with a strong prey drive. I'm not quite sure. But if you're not, if you just want a family dog like we did, you should probably ask the breeder that you're getting him from, you know, what the prey drive is of the parents, because that's often kind of passed down. And also you can train them from really young not to chase after, you know, he's not allowed to chase after joggers, he's not allowed to chase after bikes or squirrels or anything. So I, you know, made sure to teach him that right away, that that's not okay. So yeah, poodles are just, like I said, they're super versatile dogs. You can do so much with them. You can enroll them in basically any kind of dog training course. They will absolutely excel at it because they're so intelligent. Sometimes I felt like the stuff that he had to learn was like too easy for him, because he could do it after like one or two tries, versus the other dogs where you have to like do it over and over again. So they will excel at pretty much any kind of dog training course that you want to do. If you want to do agility, if you want to do obedience, and yeah, you can really take them anywhere. That's why I've also found, like, you know, if I'm going somewhere, he has been to the bank with me. He's been pretty much everywhere. Like, I always take him with me. Some people say that poodles don't do well home alone, but then really does any dog, because most dogs are pack animals. They don't like to be alone. I have left him alone for, I think, maximum like 3 or 4 hours, and it was fine. I recommend, is if you do leave them home alone, is to just take him on a long walk right before, so that he can go to the bathroom and really get all his energy out, and then usually like he'll just be sleeping at home. So hasn't really been an issue for us. He's never destroyed anything, really. I mean, the only thing he has destroyed is like his stuffed animals, but like he's allowed to destroy those. And I think that really is because he gets enough exercise and he gets enough like stimulation, so he doesn't feel like the need to compensate for lack thereof. So yeah, they're absolutely wonderful dogs, super super loving and affectionate. Like, they're just so wonderful dogs. Like I said, a lot of people have kind of a, you know, wrong opinion about them. They think they're very frou-frou and they're just very silly and, oh look, tickle 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 tickle. Yeah, I think they're kind of very silly dogs, and I think, you know, they've gotten that rap partially because of the hairstyles that they do in dog shows. And you know, the reason they do those hairstyles is because when you're in a dog show and showing a poodle, you have to do certain styles. Like the continental clip is the one that's, I think, most popular. Be prepared for just a super fun, loving family dog that gets along pretty much with anybody. Oh, I love them. I honestly can't imagine any other dog breed right now, because I just love a poodle so much. Very sporty and very fun. He makes my run so much more fun. Oh, look at him. He loves scratches right here. Look at him. Oh yeah, scratchy scratch. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys have learned a little bit more about standard poodles. And if you are considering this breed, I hope this video has helped you out. Thank you guys so much for watching. Odin says goodbye. Bye. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.